There are several steps to the IVF process, from starting fertility meds to embryo transfer. Not everybody gets through all of the steps. Fertility doctors call this a canceled cycle. Learn the common reasons why IVF cycles get canceled. IVF cycles start with the use of fertility meds to get multiple eggs to develop. Women who are at greater risk for not responding to fertility drugs are older women and women with poor ovarian reserve. Some women may have no eggs develop at all. Others may have a small number develop. Doctors will try to increase the chance of getting eggs to develop by using a more aggressive treatment protocol. But even then, some cycles will not make it to egg retrieval. So what are your chances for getting canceled before the egg retrieval? If you are under the age of 35, about 1 in 20 cycles gets canceled. Over age 35 women have about a 1 in 10 chance for getting canceled before egg retrieval. By age 40, the risk is about 1 in 5, and by 43 or 44, it's about a 1 in 4 chance. Okay, let's say you make it to the point of getting your eggs retrieved. How likely is it that you will not make it to have an embryo transfer? There are several reasons why women have their IVF cycles canceled during this phase. Some women might not have gotten any eggs from their egg retrieval. Others may have gotten eggs, but the eggs were not usable because they were degenerated or immature. Sometimes the eggs don't fertilize when sperm are added, and finally, some fertilized eggs will not grow and develop. Of those women who made it to egg retrieval and are under the age of 35, 28% of them will not make it to the point of having an embryo transfer. By the early 40s, that risk has increased to almost 40%, and by the mid-40s, roughly half of those women who made it to egg retrieval will not have an embryo transfer. It's important to understand that these numbers come from large groups of women going through IVF. Doctors are good at making predictions for large groups. We're terrible for making predictions for individuals. So now that you know these numbers, you will still have to decide whether to attempt IVF or not. Our Infertility TV bottom line: if you are going to pursue treatment with IVF, it is important for you to understand how likely it is that you will be able to complete the treatment. This may not be obvious just when discussing pregnancy rates. You're probably thinking to yourself, wow, this was a pretty good video. I learned a lot. So go ahead and like this video now. Then enjoy this playlist about IVF, but don't forget to subscribe to Infertility TV. It's like having a fertility specialist on your phone.